After diet, we'll be discussing about exercise. So exercise which a diabetic person can do is of two types. One is aerobic exercise and another is anaerobic exercise. Aerobic exercise is like walking, brisk morning walk or brisk evening walk. By brisk, it means that walking at such a speed that your arms swing naturally, also walking at such a speed that you do get sweating, and walking at such a speed that you get to cover at least 1.5 mile in an hour's time. So walking at this speed will cause you spontaneous sweating. Brisk morning or brisk evening walk for at least 30 minutes a day or at least 150 minutes a week is recommended for all diabetic patients. This walking will lead to control of or balancing of your plasma glucose. Apart from that, this walking will also result in reduction in blood pressure. This will also help in keeping you cardiovascularly fit. Not only that, if the person is having pre-diabetes and he is being into doing brisk morning or brisk evening walk 30 minutes a day or at least 150 minutes a week, then it has been seen that the progression of pre-diabetes to diabetes is also delayed. Not only this, if the patient or the person is not being able to manage 150 minutes a week of moderately vigorous aerobic physical activity like walking, like jogging, then he can also choose to have 75 minutes of severely vigorous aerobic activity a week, like swimming. Apart from that, twice a week, anaerobic activity of at least 75 minutes in a week should also be done, which is also called resistance training exercises, like weightlifting. This helps to keep the patient fit from cardiovascular standpoint and also from diabetes standpoint. This recommendation is for adults. For children who are obese or for children who are either diabetic or for children who are in pre-diabetes range, because as you know that childhood obesity has grown to epidemic proportion nowadays in India, the recommendation is 60 minutes of moderately vigorous activity per day. So it is double of what is adult recommendation. Apart from diet and exercise, role of a sound sleep is also paramount, particularly for a healthy life. For those who are pre-diabetic, this is even more vital. For those who are not even pre-diabetic, this is also vital. A sound sleep delays onset of diabetes. This is a correct statement, but even more correct is to say that if the patient's sleep is not sound or if the person's sleep is not sound, then this leads to progression of diabetes and also progression from pre-diabetes to diabetes, because it has been seen that if the patient's sleep is incomplete, either because he snores at night, he or she snores at night, or for any or other reason, it has been seen that the insulin which is released from pancreas in the body, they do not get to act or they are unable to act properly in the peripheral tissue. This leads to either progression into pre-diabetes range for person who are healthy at time at this moment and progression into diabetes for persons who are pre-diabetic at this moment. For healthy sleeps, we need to first important thing is everybody knows we need to take time out from our busy schedule and keep at least 10 to 12 hours or maybe 10 hours at least reserved for sleeping. And before we sleep, we need to cut ourselves, our mind out from all other work related issues so that we can have sound sleep. Even after that, if our partner or whosoever is witnessing us during sleep complains us that you are snoring at night, then this should not be taken lightly, and it can be due to obstructive sleep apnea, which can lead to progression of diabetes. And so you should consult your doctor for this, that to rule out whether you are having such problem or not.